So here's what you can expect. We will see mostly sunny skies this afternoon. Near normal temperatures today and tomorrow, highs in the lower 90s. So it's hot, it's not too humid out there, and we've got some tropical moisture coming on Thursday. Have you heard about Elsa? Yeah, we're going to see showers likely on Thursday, but it's going to be a quick mover. It's going to be drier on Friday, upper 80s, and hot again on Saturday, low 90s, but it'll be dry just like today. So let's take a look at the latest satellite picture. There's been shower bands moving through South Florida and the Keys. You see that little convection explode. The center of the storm is northwest of Cape Hatteras, south of Tampa, and it's moving to the north-northwest at about 13 miles per hour. Well, north-northwest at 10 miles per hour. I stand corrected. So here's what it looks like. Sometime tomorrow morning, it'll come ashore in Florida, but before it does, it's going to batter the west coast and the Tampa area. You're going to hear all about that later today with some surge coming into the Tampa Bay and such with this storm that might intensify to a 70-mile-an-hour wind, so it might strengthen a little bit over the Gulf of Mexico before it starts to weaken again, all the way down to 40 miles per hour by Wednesday evening. So there's your Wednesday path. We're concerned about Thursday. Good news is it'll be a tropical depression, so we don't have to worry about tropical storm force winds. Still going to come up the I-95 corridor. This path has been pretty consistent for the last 12 or 18 hours, so that's a good sign. It's narrowing the weather window of uncertainty. 35-mile-an-hour possible winds. It's going to strengthen again when it comes off the coast of Norfolk and maybe be a tropical storm up through Boston or at least Nantucket as it moves toward the Canadian Maritimes. But I want you to emphasize 8 a.m. on Thursday, 8 p.m. on Thursday. In between, we'll get some rain. We got rain last Friday. I think these amounts are going to be similar to what we had last Friday when it wasn't a tropical system. It was just a cold front coming through. I'm thinking 1 to 2 inches, but possibly up to 3 inches, especially along the path of the storm. So 1 to 3 inches, but look how quickly it falls off. So if the storm were to shift further east, so would the rain. If it shifts further to the west, obviously some of that heavier rain could fall in Durham and such, where they're right now expected less than an inch. There is a marginal risk for maybe a damaging wind or isolated tornado east of I-95, so we're really not into that. But if you are watching us, Wilson and Goldsboro and Sampson County, you got to keep an eye out because that'll be the most unstable part of the storm, really, toward the coast. And that is for during the day on Thursday. And wind gusts, maybe 20, 30 mile per hour winds, that's not the type of wind that's going to damage anything in terms of a severe thunderstorm.